As journalists, we have to ask ourselves that if dissent cannot get attention, then what is dissent? There is a theatre in which dissent operates. If that theatre and audience is not there, then the dissent is being nullified. And that is what political power today has to understand. What the Arab Spring and the Anna movement and Occupy Wall Street is showing is that there is a great unrest. It is badly articulated, because what is troubling is that people's movements have always had a very nuanced articulation of how the world should be. Today, we are having upsurges without even an understanding of how a world should be. So I'll come back finally to the last point I want to make, which is that even before there is action on the ground, we have to correct our discourse. We have to correct our language. The reason India came into being, we were a feudal, colonial, illiterate, poor society. But for a moment, we had wonderful visionary leaders. They spoke a language of inspiration. We lived in a climate of inspiration. And overnight, we could give ourselves a modern democracy, adult franchise, you know, a lot of levels of social justice. They were imagined overnight. We didn't think that we were ready for it, but the society rose to that. We have lived by that covenant for 63 years. Today, what I find appalling in the media, and increasingly in civil society, and then certainly in the political class, is this absence of language, is this climate of inspiration. Once we begin to speak the correct language, this same society will rise to that task. And I hold ourselves in the media responsible, and certainly political class, and that was what was so disturbing about the Anna movement, that the rhetoric came down. And if even the civil movements are going to speak a debased language, then we really lost as a society.